Alrighty, 5-6 students. Our focus for our Thursday Friday of this week is location and transformation, and both activities center around the Cartesian plane. This is the Cartesian plane here. You'll notice it's got a zero in the middle, a Y and an X, so that's the Y axis here, this line, okay, and the X axis here, and they cross at the zero point, okay? So if you've ever seen coordinates before and done any work with mapping and that kind of thing, you might have seen it in just the first quarter of the Cartesian plane, okay? It actually goes, it's got three other sections, all which use negative numbers, okay? And this quarter here uses negative numbers on the x-axis and on the y-axis, and I'm gonna go into that now. You'll need an understanding of the Cartesian plane for both activities, for your transformation activity, where you're drawing objects from one side of the Cartesian plane to the other. And in the treasure hunt activity, you'll also need it to locate the treasure, and it'll use the whole Cartesian plane, okay? So I can rub that off now. If you can walk away from this vid with a bit of an understanding as to how to locate different items on the Cartesian plane, then that's been really successful, okay? Well done. There's no success criteria at this stage because I'm just explaining it. So let's get into it. We always say the x-axis first, okay, then the y-axis. Easy way to remember that is x comes before y in the alphabet. So x-axis, then the y. For example, if I'm looking for a location 3, 4, then x-axis first is 3. So I'm here, and then 4, which is there. So I go up to this point, and I mark it like so, okay? That is point 3, 4, and I can write 3, 4, and I've separated the x-axis and the y-axis with a comma, okay? And that's important as well. If you have letters on there, you could just write F7. You don't need a comma because we're using alphanumeric, so we're using letters and numbers, so you don't need the comma. But as you get older and more advanced with this, it's numbers both times, okay? So with a negative, remember, we always work away from zero, which is why the numbers are increasing going up and increasing going this way. So this way, -1, -2, or -3, -4, and the same going down, -1, -2, -3, -4. It doesn't matter if you call them negative or minus, that really doesn't matter. So now, if I'm looking for a location that's -3, 4, first, x-axis, -3, so I'm here, and I need to go to 4, which is here. So -3 to 4 is this point here, and I'll mark it in the same way, -3, 4. Now you can also have references or coordinates that are the same, that are negative on both. Okay, so let's say I've got -3, -2. All right, and I would write that, actually I'll do it first. -3 is on, so what did I say? -3, -2. Okay, so -3 or -3 is on the x-axis and -2 on the y-axis. So I'm going to come into about here, and there's my spot, and I write that -3, -2. Okay, it's a bit messy, but, and I've done this pretty roughly, but I'm working the best I can with these tools. Okay, so there's our point. Remember, just have a go at it. You might get it wrong, you might muck it up, it doesn't matter. If you're unsure about any of these activities, just check in at 1 o'clock, ask your teacher if you can, and or re-watch this video, and there's other videos explaining how to do the two activities as well. So good luck, you'll be fine.